गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन, आई एम जय पटेल, आई एम फ्रॉम मेडिसिन फर्स्ट ईयर सेक्शन सी। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट एनाटॉमी ऑफ द हार्ट, सो लेट्स मूव ऑन। सो लोकेशन ऑफ योर हार्ट इज लोकेटेड बिटवीन योर लंग्स इन मिडल ऑफ योर चेस्ट बिहाइंड एंड स्लाइटली लेफ्ट टू द ब्रेस्ट बोन। द हार्ट इज सराउंडेड बाय अ डबल लेयर्ड मेम्ब्रेन कॉल्ड एज द पेरिकार्डियम एंड इट इज बेसिकली लाइक अ सैक। So the chambers of your heart. Basically, the heart is made up of four chambers. Two upper chambers known as the right atrium and left atrium, and the two lower chambers known as the right ventricle and left ventricle. Heart is also made up of four valves: mitral valve, aortic valve, tricuspid valve, and pulmonary valve. So the first valve is mitral valve. Mitral valve is located between left atrium and left ventricle. The next one is the aortic valve. Aortic valve is located between the left ventricle and aorta. Then next one is tricuspid valve. Tricuspid valve is located between right atrium and right ventricle. And the last one is pulmonary valve. It is located between the right ventricle and the pulmonary artery. So the heart walls consist of the three layers of tissue. First one, myocardium. It is the muscular tissue of the heart. The next one is endocardium. This tissue lines inside of the heart and it protects the walls and chambers of the heart. Pericardium is a thin protective coating that surrounds the other parts. And epicardium, it is the protecting layer which is mostly consist of connective tissue. Let's discuss about the right side of the heart. So the right side, it receives the deoxygenated blood and sends it into the lungs. Right atrium receives the deoxygenated blood via inferior and superior vena cava. The inferior and superior vena cava, which are the vein and which are the largest veins of our body, when the right atrium is full, blood it contracts and blood passes into the right ventricle. Then when right ventricle is full, the blood passes into the lungs and it passes via the pulmonary artery. So in the lungs, blood picks up the oxygen and offloads the carbon dioxide. Left side of the heart. So the left side receives the blood from the lungs and passes it into the other body parts. So the newly oxygenated blood returns to the left atrium via the pulmonary veins. Once the left atrium is full, it contracts and sends the blood into the left ventricle. So once left ventricle is full, it contracts and blood flow comes back. The normal range of heartbeat is approximately 60 to 100 beats per minute. Each heartbeat consists of two main parts, diastole and systole. In diastole, the atria contracts and pumps blood into the ventricles. So in this condition, ventricles are relaxed and filled with blood. In systole, the ventricle contracts and pumps blood out of the heart. So in this condition, atria is filled with blood and relaxed. When a person takes their blood pressure, the machine will give high and low number. The high number is the systolic blood pressure and the lower number is the diastolic blood pressure. Atherosclerosis. Atherosclerosis is also called as atherosclerotic cardiovascular heart disease. Atherosclerosis can lead to a heart attack and strokes. There are several reasons, including high cholesterol level, high blood pressure, and smoking, leading to this fatty materials buildup. If fatty deposits break down, it can cause a clots around it and it can block your artery. So there are many chances of heart attacks. Coronary heart disease. In this condition, damage or disease occur in the heart's major blood vessels. High blood pressure. It is also known as hypertension. It is a condition in which the force of blood against the artery wall is too high. Cardiac arrest. In this condition, sudden unexpected loss of heart's function breathing and consciousness occurs. So in this video we discuss about anatomy of heart, functions of heart and some heart diseases. Thanks for watching.